was very conscious of how privileged I was. And I knew that my friends were working in manual work, many of them carpenters, farming, helping in farms, driving tractors, working on the roads, working in the forestry. And I was working in dead of winter in a small, warm projection room watching cowboy films. This was paradise. I felt like saying, it doesn't matter, I'll work for nothing.
Yeah.
Whatever the wages are, I'll do it. I didn't really care.
I started as an amateur filmmaker. I joined a cine club back in the early 70s and used to spend the weekends out filming with friends. It was really the Streatham and Tooting Cine Club, but somebody decided to call it Echinoid, which is apparently the name of a fossilised sea urchin. But it sounded better than the Streatham and Tooting Cine Club. What do I do here? Anything technical. Projection, microphones, lighting, anything technical, and anything that needs to be done technically. If you go to the cinema, you never hear the projector running. If you're in the projection booth, you do. But as a part of the audience, you don't hear the projector running. So when you're running films at home on a 16mm or 8mm projector, they want the projector noise in the room, going, you know, running the purring noise. That's not part of the film experience, or it shouldn't be. That's part of the mechanics of showing film.
There's the whirring of the projector constantly, so it can be difficult to be part of the film, and you're listening to the soundtrack through a dedicated speaker in the box that can be set at different levels, and if necessary, turned off altogether. Although I always find that's very unsettling, to look out at the picture and see people mouthing without being able to hear what they're saying. And in fact, not to know whether the sound is still working, because it could go off, as it occasionally does, through faults, and you wouldn't know until some manager came bursting in breathlessly to tell you it's gone wrong.
Well, they'll be fixed in a minute. They'll tear the piece apart. Well, can't you take something to them? Dirty old man always did.
The only time people think about a projectionist is when the picture goes wrong. As a boy, as a teenager, of course, the machine was running away, the picture was on the screen, the cinema was full. And I would think, if I put that switch off, these people's whole evening comes to an end.
The story is, of course, the show must go on. But you really need to do this full time. But that's not the same as putting on a full-scale whole evening of film involving closing and opening curtains on the stage or screen. You've got different lighting, footlights and battens producing different lights on these curtains. There was a whole amount of what is termed showmanship, and by accident being so involved has let the reel run out by mistake. I used to nod off sometimes.
This is a reel of 35mm film, which would last about 20 minutes at sound speed. The feature films we run on individual reels, and every 20 minutes there'll be a changeover from one machine to the other. So we have two identical machines here with 1,000-watt Xenons on them. You open the lamp and close the lamp on this one, and the picture changes from one machine to the other without anybody noticing. That's how it should happen.
I did want to have my own cinema. So this, I could see, was very, very simple. Two projectors, a screen, and a loudspeaker, and you had your own cinema. I bought a car for £7.50 in an auction, and it was such a beautiful, lovely car, a really nice car. But, you know, I was only on £5 a week wages. So I bought a car and then started my cinema business.
This is a small lamp house from slide. It's a slide lantern that shows announcements between the films. So in here, there are two carbon rods vertical like this. And in a moment, I'll touch them together and then pull them apart, and an electric arc will jump across, making the ends of the carbons white hot and producing light. Now, this rectifier here sat underneath the back of one projector, and it's a small output. So this is just a junior model.
How do you say it, sorry?
I don't say it. It sounds, it looks like an Evelector.
Well, I'm a big Disney enthusiast. When I was about 12, I went to the Odeon in St Albans on a one-day show, a Fantasia, Disney's Fantasia. And I sat through it twice, and over the years, every chance I've had to go and see it, I've seen it. And in those days, they were continuous performance. The film finished and then they showed it again and then they showed it again. You could stay there all day. We would go in halfway through one film and then watch the end of the film, and then they'd watch the next film, and then they'd watch the beginning of the film that they'd missed when they came in, and then leave halfway through the film because they caught up with the rest of the story. That was normal.
When I was a child, my mother ran off with a soldier because she'd realised she was pregnant. They'd been having an affair secretly. And so from the age of five, I was brought up by my father only. And he didn't have a lot of time to dedicate to, he was very dedicated in looking after me, but he didn't have a lot of time to spend with me. So I had a lot of leeway, a lot of freedom. So on Saturday, you went out to play and you disappeared for the whole day and nobody worried about where you were. I used to go in the hills, which were covered with ferns and undergrowth, and we'd play cowboys and Indians and imitate some of the things we'd seen in the films. You know, it was all and so on.
That's the one, Conquest the Door. It's a comedy.
Now, one thing.
I'm afraid film in the cinema is finished. You know, there is virtually no film left. And there's not going to be any more because the equipment's all been destroyed. Cinemas, most of the cinemas have destroyed. Odeon had a policy of destroying the projectors, so they broke them up and put them in a skip.
We've run out!
There isn't any going back because the industry that made film projectors has gone. The maintenance people who maintain cinema equipment have all had to do something else because there's no industry for them. A number of film collectors, I won't say a lot of them, but a number that I know are totally anti-DVD. It's not the same, and they prefer to have an 8mm copy, maybe scratched and full of joins that doesn't compare with a DVD or a Blu-ray that's come off the original camera negative and looks stunning.
The 70s and 80s were terrible. It was way down, but the Americans brought it, I think, back up with the multiplexes. Good sound equipment and very, very good technical levels. Cinema's on and up at the moment.